'Tis the season for snow. As fun as it is to imagine Jack Frost's best friend Snip cutting each individual snowflake, that's not how snow forms, unfortunately. Two key components are needed for a good snowstorm. First, there needs to be cold air that's below freezing to make snow. It must be cold in the atmosphere and cold near the ground to prevent snow from melting as it falls. Second, moisture is needed to form clouds and precipitation. Very cold air won't hold much water vapor, so temperatures have to be just right for snow. Snowflakes are made of as many as 200 ice crystals. They have a hexagonal structure and can be symmetrical, although some are not. Snowflakes are very similar in their shape and formation. Snow forms in clouds when ice crystals form around dust and debris particles. Ice crystals continue to grow around the particles, becoming heavy enough to fall toward Earth. On average, 10 inches of snow melted is around an inch of water. This varies depending on how much snow a location typically sees. If temperatures are below freezing in the atmosphere and on the ground, most likely you'll see snow. When forecasting a winter storm, meteorologists pay close attention to the atmospheric and surface conditions to know exactly what type and how much precipitation an area will have. If surface temperatures are below freezing and the air is moist, heavy wet snow will land on the ground. If the air is very cold, then dry powdery snow will fall. The ideal snow that all kids look forward to is a heavy wet snow, perfect for snowball fights, forts, and snowmen. Enjoy your winter and happy holidays. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to Mr. Weather's World on YouTube for new videos every Mr. Weather Wednesday.